Hello students, today we will discuss about JEE Mains 2015 physics paper. Now we will discuss all the questions one by one. Okay, let us start. Students, let us solve the next question. Question number 4. A particle of mass m moving in x direction with a speed, so there is a particle of mass m moving in x direction with velocity 2v and hit by another particle of mass 2m moving in y direction with a velocity v. So this is moving in x direction, this is moving in y direction, they collide and the collision is perfectly inelastic. That means after collision this will be the situation 1 and 2m. So this is m, this is 2m, the whole mass will be 3m and they will move with certain speed, say v dash. Now the perfectly inelastic collision implies that the first body will stick to the second object and both the objects will move together with a certain common velocity. The percentage loss in the energy during the collision is close to, so you're basically you want to find the percentage loss of energy because it is perfectly inelastic collision, so therefore there will be loss of kinetic energy that we have to find in terms of percentage. So first of all we have to find what is the initial kinetic energy, suppose that is k1 of the system. Then you have to find the final kinetic energy, this is before collision and this is after collision. Before collision the kinetic energy is found to be half m, this is v square, that is 4 v square, plus kinetic energy of this half m, m is 2m, v square, v square is v square. So if I solve this, then this is 2 cancels, here also 2 cancels, is 2mb square plus mb square, it is 3mb square. This is equation 1. So before the collision the two objects combined together as total kinetic energy 3mb square. Now after collision let us see what is the kinetic energy, because they are moving together with the common velocity say v prime, so kinetic energy is half m, here m will be 3m because they are moving together, into v prime square. Now this is one equation, suppose this is equation number 2, but then you have to find v prime to relate v prime in terms of v. So how to do that? So now apart from this kinetic energy equation division, we have to use one momentum equation to solve the question. Let us use the principle of conservation of momentum. Conservation of momentum says that the total momentum before and after will be equal. So before what was the total momentum? Now the thing is one was moving in this direction, the first object was moving in this direction, its momentum was, its mass was m and velocity is 2v, so 2mb in this direction. The second object was moving in y direction, its mass was m, mass was 2m and moving with v, so it is also 2mb. So this is the first particle which is moving in I cap direction, this is the second particle which is moving in j cap direction. They are in 90 degrees to each other. So the total momentum before is found to be, because momentum is a vector quantity, so you have to find and these two vectors are equal and 90 degree, so therefore it will be root 2 times whatever is present. That is 2mv, that implies it is 2 root 2mv. This is the momentum before collision. And what is the momentum after collision? The momentum is, so this is before case, and after is the mass is 3m and moving with certain velocity, say momentum should be equal. Okay, so the magnitude of momentum must be same. So I'll write that 3m v prime must be equal to, okay, that 2 root 2 m v. If it was in this direction, 45 degree, obviously it will move like that. Then after this has to move in this direction, this v prime has to move in that direction, and the direction momentum before and momentum after will be same, and it is in the same direction, making an angle of 45 degree. Here is 45 degree, and the magnitude should be same, before and after should be equal, because conservation of momentum is momentum principle holds even if the collision is elastic or inelastic. So 2m v prime equals to 2 root 2 mv. From here I can cancel out this, and v prime can be written as 2 by 3 root 2 v. So this is equation number 3. If I use this equation in the equation number 2 over here, what I will get? I will get k2 equals to 3 by 2 m v dash square. Now v dash comes out to be this square of this, so let us find v dash square. So v dash square is 4 by 9, this becomes 2, and this is v square, 8 by 9 v square. So this is 8 by 9 v square. 2, 4 is 8, 3, 3 is 9, so 4 by 3 mv square. This is your equation number 2 basically. So you can see here, initially the kinetic energy is 3 mv square, now it is 4 by 3 mv square. That is a decrease in kinetic energy. So now I will write those two equations once again and then solve for the percentage change. Now the initial kinetic energy is 3 mv square, the final kinetic energy is 4 by 3 mv square. So from here we have to find the percentage change or percentage loss in kinetic energy. So I'm talking about the loss in kinetic energy. So I'll just subtract these two. What I'm interested in, I have to find k1 minus k2 divided by k1 into 100. This is my aim, and I want to find this. To find this, let us take one more. Now, how to find this? Okay. Now, I have this k1 value here, k2 value here. Just I have to put it and get the answer. There is nothing much to do, but still we'll put it here. 3 mb square minus 4 by 3 mb square here. Okay. So 3 mb square minus 4 by 3 mb square. This is k1, this is k2, k1 minus k2 divided by k1, k1 is 3 mb square into 100. This is the percentage loss in kinetic energy. Percentage loss in kinetic energy. This comes out to be mb square, mb square, mb square cancel out, and this is 3 minus 4 by 3 divided by 3 into 100. This comes out to be, this is 9 minus 4, that is 5 by 3. This is 5 by 3 divided by 3 into 100. This is 5 by 9 into 100. So this is 50 by 9 into 10. I can write this 50 by 9 into 10. This can be written as 50 by 9. Then 9 5 is a 45. 45. If you solve it, approximately you will get 56%. And that is the answer. Okay. So the correct answer is 56%. Okay. Thank you.